Morning guys, and as promised, it's Saturday, and today I'm at the Japanese Classic Car event. It's a Touge run for California. This is, I think, the first official Touge run for California. Of course, Touge comes from Japan. It's a really well-known event out there. And so they finally brought it down here for everybody to enjoy. Everybody with a pre-1980 Japanese classic car will be able to join in. We're in Lake Wolford right now. As you can see, it's this beautiful mountainous lake up here. It's rather small, but you know, it's cool. We'll have a good time up here. Cars are starting to roll in. It's in the top of the event right now, as you can see. We've got several different cars pulling up already. The event starts at 10 o'clock, but I believe we will be getting going here at the driver's meeting at 10:30. So I'll kind of show you guys around and you can see what we're looking at today. Oh, look at this old Honda pulling up. This thing is so tidy. Got a little old Civic here, yellow one. Thing's a beauty. So clean, it's like it just came out of the dealer. Same with this nice looking Celica. Everybody's firing up here, some trying. Of course, you know, as these old cars are never super reliable. That's why we have fuel injection. This old school Datsun 240 right here, looking pretty in yellow. This, if you guys are into Subarus, you'll of course love this one. Pardon the glare. I've got a little sun shining through, but that's okay. This one's nice. Yeah. I read it. I could have told me we had to back in the beginning. And if you don't already know, this is a invitation-only event. So basically, everybody gets together, you submit your application, and they review the car to see if it qualifies based on what they want.
You gotta see the engine on this.
Keep going. Ooh, so pretty and clean. What's in this thing right now?
It's a L28 that's been modified. Cans and ported and typical car.
Very nice. What kind of power do you think you're putting down?
I'm not sure.
You didn't tell me. I just got this car out in January.
Still trying to figure it out, huh? Yeah. Putting all the pieces of the puzzles together. Very beautiful interior. Very clean. Love it. If you guys like classic sedans, this is a politician's car right here. Old, good old Datsun Roadster with a hardtop, looking beautiful over here. Very nice. As you can see, everybody's gathering up over here. We have a driver's meeting at 10:30. And this is the car that we actually came in today. This is a 1971. It's making about 320 horsepower. The thing is beauty. It's got all the bits and pieces already set up for it. All the suspension's done. Everything is great. It's gonna be awesome. Just gonna go around and show you basically what we have here, all the different cars and what they look like. Another 240.
The glass on glass construction. Yeah. We got things to do this year.
Shiny green Celica.
I have to text Mike.
Who is the Celica?
One of you.
This one.
Number. I think it's just one.
That's really great. I miss my rotary truck.
So that was a brief roundup of all the cars that showed up for the event today. The driver's meeting coming up at 10:30. However, we haven't started yet, so it's just a bit 5 after 10:30, so it's not a big deal. We're probably gonna get started here soon.
This looks like everyone. All right, well, welcome to Touge California 2016. My name is Patrick Strong. I'm the rally master for this event. On behalf of my partner Ben Shu of Japanese Nostalgic Car, I'd like to thank you all very much for bringing your beautiful cars out to be with us today. We've got about 200 miles of driving ahead of us, so I hope you're ready. Before I get into the orientation, I just want to give a quick thank you to our very generous sponsors today. So thank you to Koyorad Radiator and Yokohama Tire for their support. Model Citizen Diecast, thank you, Model Citizen.
I'm Model Citizen.
Oh yeah, it's me. Haggerty Collector Car Insurance was a major sponsor of our event this year, and I will be speaking a little bit more about them later. And of course, we would be nowhere without our title sponsor, Mazda. So a big round of applause. Jacob Brown here. This man has done an incredible job organizing us around this, and without giving anything away, he has just really put together something very special for us at the end of the day. I can't wait for you guys to see it, but we have some business to do first. So, as I said, we've got about 200 miles of driving today. There will be at times some moderately challenging sections of road. We've called those out in our route instructions, which are bound in the envelopes that you have. Those sections are identified as Touge stages. We're talking about roads that are curvy and, you know, have some elevation changes and will be very fun to drive. This is not a race. I want to say that again as clearly as I can. Touge California is not a race, nor is it a timed competition in any respect. We do expect you to follow all traffic laws and speed limits at all times. There will be ample opportunity for spirited driving in the hills, but please keep it in your pants to the best of your ability. And those of you who were a part of this last year, and I know that's not very very many of you, but I'll just query one of them. Smith McGay, what's my one overarching rule today?
Don't cross the double yellow line.
Do not cross the double yellow line unless you are taking evasive action. Unless you are taking evasive action to avoid a collision, do not do it. We are sharing the roads today with, I'm sure you saw, we had a lot of motorcyclists out there, other, you know, civilian drivers. There are going to be some photographers set up along the route. We have a lot of media support this year. Thank you, media, for coming out. Yeah. If you see people by the side of the road taking your picture, don't stop. Just keep going. All right. The point is for them to get you in motion. So, all right. The route instructions. In the brown envelopes that you have is a wire-bound route book. This includes your route instructions. The route instructions are only intended to help you. If you've ever done some like SCCA course rallies, you know that sometimes they build things in to try to confuse you. This is not that. All we want you to do is stay on course, because if you're off course, you're not having fun, and we want you to have fun today. So to help you stay on course, we have helpfully included official mileage in the rally. If you take a look, there's a column here that has the official mileage in miles and kilometers, if you happen to have a kilometer reading odometer in your car.
Thank you.
These mileages are tied to something in the route instructions, whether it's where you turn or whether it's a sign that you're supposed to spot. We do this so that you don't have to spend all day looking for signs. We want you to get to enjoy the rally, enjoy the beautiful scenery that we're going to have. But you do want to pay attention to these numbers, because they will be your clue that you need to be doing something at some point. Also, at the very front of the book, or not the very front, but ahead of the instructions, is a glossary of terms. There's nothing really complicated about this. It's just that we use a couple of words in a very specific way, like observe, for example. That means you're looking for a sign. If you are looking for a sign, you'll know that it's a sign because it's in quotation marks. If you see quotation marks, you're looking for exactly what's inside those quotation marks for the sign. Again, not intended to confuse you, only intended to help you. So, checkpoints. There are going to be 6 checkpoints along the way today. The procedure for entering a checkpoint is, you're looking for, there will be a big white and red checkpoint sign with the toge kanji on it. That will be leaning against the official vehicle where the checkpoint staff is. Go to them, either in your vehicle or walk up to them and check in. So there's the sign. Hand painted by our lovely checkpoint worker, Natalie Strong.
Nice. Very nice.
Check in with them, make sure they know that you're there, and then there will be some other things to do at the checkpoints. Each checkpoint has a pause time on it. That's how long you need to stay at that checkpoint. We're going to do our best to release you, you know, after that time is over. We need to keep our schedule pretty tight today, because we do have some kind of special things planned along the route, but they are tied to time, so keep tight. Okay, here's how this is going to work. Joe, come forth. This is Joe Batwes. He's our sweep car driver. Joe is also going to be our starter at the start. So, if you are holding car numbers 1 through 13, you are in run group 1. I'd like you to leave in that order. Joe, the start location will be at the kanji, which will be ahead on the right. So cars 1 through 13, I want you guys to line up in numerical order over there.
So as you heard, those are the rules for today. We're going to be getting going here. I'm not sure what car number we are. We are car number 2. And this is Jack, our driver for today. It's his car. We're in the 1971 240z. Say hello.
Hello, folks. How are you?
So we're going to get going here, being car number 2. That feels kind of nice. So does that mean anything, or do you think it just has to do with...
I think they think we're smarter than the rest, so we'll take the way.
You think? Maybe it has to do with fastness. Is that even a word? I'm not sure.
Maybe we're faster than everybody else, so we're ahead. They can keep up with us, that's good.
Yeah, that's right. Get that fired up. All right, here we go, guys. I'm going to get in here. We'll get started in a little bit. And now we're looking at the coordinate list here. Looks like we've got a bunch of different ways to go. That's the starting point there with this odd hieroglyph-looking logo. I'm not sure if you guys can see it. And we have all the mileage and all the lefts and rights along with the speedometer. What do you think? It's pretty self-explanatory?
Yeah, we're ready to go. Hopefully it'll be a fun day. Nice sunny day today. We're going to be testing our Rebello 320 horsepower engine. See how it does on the mountain sections. But we're supposed to be good fun.
We're supposed to be going slow today.
Yes, it's not a race. It's just a fun day.
Yeah, but you know, we'll have a good time along the way. That's
the
point.
We'll put the car through its paces, make sure everything's tight and good and running well. You know, so if need adjustment, we could always do it when we get back. But this is a great day to do this, so good group.
And as you can see, I'm running an app here that basically logs all the mileage. So I know, you know, it's like a tripodometer. It will let us know when to make lefts and rights and, you know, follow all that stuff. There's actually at the beginning of this book, there is a glossary of terms in case you don't understand it. I'm looking at this thing and checkpoint, crossroad, observe, OPP, all that stuff. Looks pretty self-explanatory, so I think we should be good to go. All right, we're getting fired up here. Looks like we're getting ready to go.
Yeah, good luck, take care. We just go at our will?
Yep.
So here we go. We're actually getting through the lake right now. We're driving through, and we're gonna be following this red RX-7, and we've got a whole crew behind us. Actually, they're probably coming up, so. Yep. So we just left the parking lot right now, basically on the first leg of the event. We're just headed toward Valley Center Road right now. There's a little Nissan Murano that we're stuck behind, but it's no big deal. I'm sure we're going to be gathering up a little bit later. So how does it feel, Jack?
Feels good.
Feels good. It's a really nice day, isn't it?
Day began.
Yep.
So we're ready to go.
Here's kind of a look out the window of this severe drop and this beautiful scenery here out in the mountains. We're in Escondido right now. Here. So we just started up the first stage of the rally. However, we're stuck in a little bit of traffic. Obviously, this isn't a race event, so there's going to be a lot of public traffic. So as you can see, we're stuck behind like a camper, maybe a Tacoma, a couple of regular cars, and a van. So it's going to be a slow first stage, it seems, but I think we're still just kind of enjoying the ride. It's a beautiful day. We just finished the first stage of the Touge Rally. It was a little bit slow because we were stuck behind traffic, but what can you do at this point? It is what it is. Now we're going to be making a left on the 78, so that way we can start heading over to the next round. Yeah. So we're nearing our stop right now. I believe we're about to enter Santa Isabel. This is a city out here. Should be. Yeah, that's the checkpoint. Look at that. So what's the deal with these pies? These are the famous Julian apple pies, huh?
These are.
Yeah? Let's take a look at this.
Oh, maybe we should do more photogenic pieces.
I know, right? No, this is good. This is good. This is great.
What, you want one?
Oh, I'll take that.
We all want pizza. We can smell it, too. This is good.
That's our new Mazda air freshener. Here you go.
I like it. New car smell. There's a twin. So So we're now at this Don's Market in Julian, I believe, or wherever we are. So everybody's lined up having some apple pie. Everybody's hard at work as well over here. Oh, we've got a politician that just arrived. Look at that, look at that. Little Toyota Century. Very nice. Everybody's having their apple pie over there. We've got a nice little old school Subaru that just pulled up. And here we found a parking spot a little bit further away. We're getting ready to go on the next round. You having a good time, Jack?
Yep.
Yeah?
It's a great time. Wish there was less cars on the road though.
I know, that's always the case.
We're getting ready for the next stage now. So far, so good. Everything went well. No problems. So hopefully the next stage will have less cars. We can get a little bit of speed into it. Not too much, because not too many people can handle the corners, but we'll be okay.
Now we are about to leave the first checkpoint, which we paused for 30 minutes. We're headed over, leaving from the Apple Country restaurant. We're going to be making a left over here. Everybody's kind of getting ready to go. We have the RX2 in front of us, and there's an RX7 ahead of him, I believe. So hopefully he'll stay ahead of us and we'll have some more footage with some classic cars in front of us, since we are kind of ahead of the pack. So this gentleman wants us to park right there. Perfect. Very nice. So we are second, but we are replaced that earlier RX7 with an RX2, right?
Yep.
So. So something new to look at, which is nice for us. Looks like we have a little bit of a brake problem. Just the pedal doesn't feel that great. So Jack's underneath the car trying to figure out what the deal is. Front brakes looked all right. He's checking the rears now. Looks to be okay. We have the whole first group, the stage convoy, kind of lined up waiting for us, just kind of as backup. So it's beautiful. We're kind of out in the middle of California country right here. There's cows and all different types of animals out here.
The line is loose.
Jack's working on jacking this thing up.
That's awesome. There.
And then tie it down with something here from this line.
So we're using a vice grip maybe to tie this thing down.
Yeah.
Hopefully it'll work.
I just need a zip tie. I don't have a zip tie with me. I didn't bring zip ties.
I still see a leak though.
Huh?
I still see a leak.
Okay, I'm gonna clean it.
And no, it's still leaking, like actively leaking.
Here?
On the bottom.
Okay, check when I press on the brakes. Okay?
Okay. I mean, it's active, Jack.
Okay, let me.
It was better before.
It wasn't leaking before?
It wasn't.
Okay, let me test.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, you're like spraying.
Yeah, it's not.
That's crazy.
Earlier was good.
Yeah, you're spraying fluid.
Yeah.
And it's actually a second hole further down.
I had it down pretty good earlier. I shouldn't have let
it
go. Okay, what's that? Let's see. This is not enough grip on it. For some reason, it's getting loose.
We were able to get this thing contained with this vice grip here. So now we're gonna tape it in place so that way it can we can prevent it from moving around, and hopefully we can have some brakes. Until at least we can get to a checkpoint or somewhere where we can kind of comfortably change out this situation, or maybe just have the car towed home. And as you can see, we are in the middle of a road in the middle of nowhere at this point. But everybody's been great. They're helping us out.
Oh yeah, good. One more going down.
So we got the wheel back on. And Jack is lowering the car now, so I think we'll have some pedal pressure, some brakes. We can limp back to the checkpoint and we'll go from there. Hopefully this will hold up until we do get there, that is. So we'll just have to wait and see. Good workout, Jack?
Yeah, I'm just gonna go under the car and make sure that no suspension parts are rubbing to the vice grip.
And the wheel.
And the wheel, so make sure everything is rotating freely.
You gonna rotate the tires, man?
The tires. Oh. I think we're clear there. Barely. Kind of close though.
With vibe, you think it'll stay put?
It looks tight, but we gotta drive slow.
So we just took off right now. I don't really hear anything.
We smelled the brake.
You think that was the brake? Oh yeah, remember what, the last stop? Just go slower. How does the brake feel?
It's gonna stop.
We'll just have to listen to see if there's gonna be any weirdness. How does it feel?
It's not 100%, but it's better. I got brake feel, so.
So we're basically the last in the group. There's a sweep car behind us. It's actually a brand new Miata. It looks really good. It's a ceramic white color. Anyway, so we're driving in about a mile. We're gonna actually be pulling into a parking lot so we can have some lunch. And I think at that point, we're probably gonna decide to head back just because, you know, our brake situation kind of weighs us down. It's probably dangerous to continue the rest of the drive in the state that we're in, so I think for safety's sake, we're probably gonna have to call it a day at that point. I guess we'll just have to see what happens when we get to the lunch place. Hey guys, so yep, that's basically gonna be it for us for the day. Unfortunately, we did have run into that brake problem, so it's gonna be kind of an issue for us to keep going, especially considering all the tight canyons and the tight roads that we're gonna have to go through all day long. But I did still get some good coverage. Of course, you guys got to see all the cool cars that are here. All right guys, I think that's basically it for us today. The Z is actually running. Our brakes are not good. So we're gonna try to make it home all the way down to Costa Mesa. So it's about 2 hours. Hopefully the brakes will hold up until then. Just we need to get it back to the shop. And so that way we don't have to have it towed and that whole pain in the butt. So I think we're good to go. So thanks for watching. Hope you liked the video, or you know, at least we got half the run up to lunch. So I guess we'll just, get back on this the next time they have it, and I'll be able to film the whole thing. Hopefully we won't break down then either. Good old thing about old cars is that they break down, so from time to time you have to give some love and get them fixed. All right, well, thanks for watching again. Please subscribe, thumbs up, comment if you like. Otherwise I'll talk to you guys soon.